Question number 51 is related to arithmetic highest common factor. So how to find out highest common factor of two numbers? First number is 360. The second number is 450. 360 ones are 360 and the remainder is 90. Now take down 360 here. 94s are 360, remainder is 0. So the answer HCF, highest common factor, is 90. This is the way to solve and find the highest common factor. Take the smallest number here and the largest here and divide this. Take down 360 here, 91s are 94s are. So remainder is 0, the HCF is 90. The highest number with which these two numbers are divisible, 94s are 95s are. Next, this question is related to blood relations. Salman told, what is Salman telling here? Salman is telling Rahim's son. So here Rahim's Salman is telling Rahim's son is my son's father-in-law. Who is father-in-law? Wife's father. My son's wife's father is father-in-law. So father-in-law here. Now, how is Rahim related to Salman? Now Rahim related to Salman. What Salman calls Rahim now? So Rahim's son. This is Salman's son. Rahim's son's wife. Here, daughter. Salman's son's wife's father. So these two are same kind of people. Here is Salman's son and here somebody's daughter. These two are married to each other. So his father. Here also this woman's father. Both are same, like brothers. But they are not real brothers. Due to marriage they got as brothers. So this is brother-in-law relationship. He is brother-in-law. Brother-in-law's father. So Salman's brother-in-law. Brother-in-law's father is father-in-law. So the answer is father-in-law. How to do this one? Salman told. What is Salman telling here? Rahim's son. Rahim's son is Salman's son's father-in-law. That means wife's father. So Salman's son and somebody's daughter are got married here. They got married. That means these two are at same cadre, like brothers. But not real brothers. Due to marriage, they got the link brother. So brother-in-law. Salman's brother-in-law is this person. This person's father is Rahim. So Salman, how Rahim is related to Salman means father-in-law. How Rahim is related. This Rahim is father-in-law. Brother-in-law's father is father-in-law. The next question. 53rd one. Statements are given. Three statements. So keeping in mind these statements, we have to write which conclusion is correct here. Tea is green. So tea is green color. Coffee is brown color. And milk is white color. This is given in first statement. Second statement. More than half of the town likes tea. More than half. That means more than 50%. Likes tea. Tea is green color. People who like white don't like green. That means who likes white don't like green means don't like tea. People who like white don't like green. So green is how much? Tea. More than 50%. That means this is less than 50%. White. And some people who like brown don't like white. Some people are there who like brown, they don't like white also. Then what is the conclusion? Green is more popular in the town. So more than half of the town likes tea. Tea is green color. So green is liked by more than 50% of the population. That means green is more popular in this town. Yes, first one is correct. Because more than half of the town likes tea means tea is green color. So they like green color. More than half of the town likes green color. That means more than 50%. So 60-70% like that. So green is more popular in the town. If there is more than
50% like, then that is more popular in that town. So first one is correct. Green is more popular in the town. Look at the second one. There is at least one coffee drinker who does not like tea. Is there relationship given about these two? Coffee drinker, tea drinker. What is coffee? Color is brown and tea, green. Is there any relationship between brown and green here? White, green, brown, white. So there is no relationship between coffee drinker. Coffee drinker means brown color. Tea drinker, green color. So no relationship in the next two statements or three statements about brown and green colors. So this is wrong. Only first one is correct. Option A follows. Only conclusion one follows. Because the first answer is, first conclusion is correct and the second one is, we are not able to find out from these given statements. So second one is wrong. So first is correct and second is wrong. Only conclusion one follows. Next, look at question number 54. The rupee sign, the symbol, was adopted by government of India in the year. This rupee symbol, previously rupee symbol was RS or RE. Now rupee symbol is this one. This is like Hindi letter Ra, rupaya, rupee. So this symbol is adopted on July 15, 2010 by the government of India. July 15, 2010. Then how they got this symbol means, they kept an open competition for this symbol. So whoever gives this symbol, rupee symbol, so total Indian public participated in this challenge, and this symbol was given by Uday Kumar from IIT Bombay. So his symbol was selected by the government of India. So this was a challenge given to Indian public. Whoever gives the symbol, they will adopt the best symbol among all the symbols received from the public. So the symbol adopted by India, Indian government, is this R symbol, Hindi Ra symbol, and a line here. This was given by Uday Kumar. Easy to remember. This is like U. This rupee symbol is like U, Uday Kumar. Uday Kumar. So U and R. His name is there in this one, Uday Kumar. So this symbol was given by Uday Kumar, IIT Bombay student at that time. So in 2010, this was adopted by government of India in July 15, 2010. Next, question number 55. The second largest river in terms of length in India. So what he asked here, the second largest, largest means in area. The second largest river means in area, which is the largest, he is asking here. Second largest, not the first largest. So area wise, rivers are different, and length wise, the high area wise and length wise, they are different. So area wise, which are the top three? Area wise, the top three are, first one is Ganga, river Ganga. Second one is Godavari. And the third one is Krishna. So total area wise means largest. Largest Indian rivers are Ganga, Godavari, and Krishna. First one is Ganga, second Godavari, third Krishna. In length wise, so length wise rivers, which are the top rivers length wise, is first one is Indus, second one Brahmaputra, third one is Ganga, and the fourth is Godavari. Lengthwise, longest rivers, these are called as longest rivers, and these are called as largest rivers. Largest means area wise. Area wise, biggest is Ganga, second is Godavari, third is Krishna. And lengthwise, that means longest, these are longest rivers. These are largest rivers. So longest rivers, first one is Indus, second is Brahmaputra, third Ganga, and fourth Godavari. Here, the second largest river. So second largest river is Godavari. This is very confusing question. What he asked is the question, the second largest river in terms of, again he asked here length. In the starting he asked the largest river, at the end he is asking again length. So it is very confusing question. You have to take only the starting point, the second largest. Largest means area wise. Area wise second largest is Godavari. If you take only length wise second largest will be different, Brahmaputra. So Brahmaputra is also there. So be careful while writing this. You have to take only the starting of the sentence, which is second largest river. In the statement here, starting only he has given the second largest river. In terms of length, which is the second longest river means, you have to write this one longest, Brahmaputra. Largest is Godavari and longest is Brahmaputra. The next one is the principal, simple interest and compound interest related problem. Question number 56. Simple interest amounts to 2000 rupees. Formula for simple interest is PTR by 100 is given as 2000 rupees. Formula for simple interest is PTR by 100 is equal to 2000. Time 2 years, rate of interest 10%. Here we will substitute those values. Principal into time. Time is 2 years. Rate of interest is 10% divided by 100 is equal to 2000. Now 0, 0 gets cancelled. 2 ones are 2000s. So principal will become 1000 into 10. 10,000 rupees is the principal borrowed. Now what is asked at last? Find the difference in the amounts of simple interest and compound interest on annual basis. We need to find out difference between simple interest and compound interest. So difference between simple interest and compound interest formula is P into R by 100 whole square. This formula you have to remember. Difference between simple interest and compound interest is P into R by 100 whole square. So what is the principal here? 10,000 into rate of interest 10% whole square. 0, 0 gets cancelled. Now this is 10,000 into 1 by 10 tens are 100. 2 zeros gets cancelled. The answer is 100. So option C is the right answer. You have to remember two formulas. Simple interest formula is PTR by 100. From that we find the value of P principal. And difference between simple interest and compound interest is P into R by 100 whole square. Principal is 10,000 and rate of interest is 10% here. 10 by 100 whole square is 1 by 100. 2 zeros gets cancelled. The answer is 100. Now what is a prime number? A prime number, what is the definition of a prime number? A prime number has only two factors, 1 and itself. Prime number should be having only two factors. If it is having two or more than two factors, then it is called a composite number. A prime number has only two factors, 1 and itself. So which is the correct option from here? It is not a positive integer, wrong. Has no divisors at all, wrong. Has one and only itself as divisors. So option C is correct here. Has only one and itself as divisors. Only two factors are there for any prime number, 1 and itself. Now look at the next question. Question number 58. Russian Sukhoi 24 flight was shot down in November 2015 by which country? So Russian Sukhoi, this is a war flight. It was shot down because it entered the border of Turkey in 2015. They warned, this Turkey country people warned. After warning also, the Russian Sukhoi entered the border of Turkey. So they shot down that war flight in 2015 November. The next question is, Ram lent rupees 6,000 to Shiva for 3 years. 6,000 rupees for 3 years. And 8,000 rupees to Krishna for 5 years at same simple interest. He got total interest of rupees 5,220. So formula for interest is PTR by 100. What is the first principle? 6,000 time 3 years. Rate of interest we don't know. divided by 100 plus it is given to Ram. The next one is to Krishna. 8000 rupees. Time is 5 years. Rate of interest not known. Divided by 100. In both cases, rate of interest is same, but the total interest is 5220 rupees. So rate of interest from Ram and rate of interest from Krishna, the total interest is 5220 rupees. Now gets two zeros gets cancelled. Here two zeros, 63s are 18, 180 R, 85s are 40, 400 R is equal to 5220. 180 plus 400 total is 580 R is equal to 5220 rupees. So R rate of interest is equal to 5220 divided by 580. 00 gets cancelled. Now cancel with two table. 2 2s are, 2 9s are, 2 2s are, 2 6s are, 2 1s are. In 29 table, let us check 29 9s are, 9 9s 81. At last one is there. 9 2s 18 plus 8 26. Yes, 29 9s are 261. So the answer rate of interest is 9%. Simple interest for Ram here. Simple interest taken on Krishna. Total is 5220. From this we calculated the rate of interest R. The 60th question is the first Indian to win an Olympic medal. We already know because the first Indian in badminton to win Olympic medal is none other than Saina Nehwal. So you know already we know this one. Badminton famous is Saina Nehwal. She won first Olympic medal for us, for India. Saina Nehwal is the correct answer. Next question number 61 to 63 is related to data interpretation. Here four students marks are given in physics and chemistry. These marks are here. Physics, chemistry, like that marks are given. Now, question number 61. What is the ratio of total marks of all the students in chemistry to that of physics in percentage? So, we need total marks of all students in chemistry and all students in physics. We have to add chemistry marks and physics marks. So, which is chemistry marks here? This one. 85 plus 85. 170 plus 55 225 plus 80 305. These are the marks in chemistry to that of physics divided by physics. We need in percentage, so it is into 100. Now physics marks, physics total 95 100 160 70 235 240 plus 70 310 into 100. Now we need to calculate this to get the answer. 003050 divided by 31. 305 tens are 3050 divided by 31. So with 31 we have to divide 3050. 31 3050. Options are above 90 all. So let us check with 9. 9 ones are 9, 9 threes are 27. Remainder is 620. 260. 31 8s are, 8 ones are 8, 8 threes are 24. 248. Remainder will be 12. Approximately 98%. 98% is the answer. Next. What is the ratio of total marks in both subjects obtained by S2 to that of S4? We need total marks of S2 and total marks. What is the ratio of total marks in both subject for S2 and S4? So S2 total marks. So S2 total marks is 80, 60, 140 plus 10, 150. S2 marks 150. And S4. S4 is scoring 70, 80, 150 plus 5, 155. So what is the ratio of total marks in both subjects? Both subjects, total marks of S2 to that of S4. We need ratio of this. 150 is to 155. Cancellation. 5 threes are 15, 0 5 threes are 15, 1 30 is to 31. So 30 by 31 is the answer.
So total marks of S2 is add these two 150 and total marks of S4 is 155. Ratio is 30 is to 31. The next question: what is the ratio of marks obtained in physics of S3?
S3's physics marks of S3 75 ratio
to that of
S1 in physics.
S1 in physics is 95.
Cancellation with 5 table, 5 15s are 5 19s are. So the answer is 15 divided by 19. Option B is the right answer.
Next,
P plus Q is equal to 2 into P 2P minus 2 into Q 2Q. So here Q is here, minus 2Q becomes plus 2Q. Here on right side we have 2P. This plus P becomes minus P. So what we get from here? 2P minus P is P is equal to 1Q plus 2Q is 3Q. So how much is Q given here in this question? The value of Q is 10. So 3 tens are 30. Option D is right. So very simple question. P plus Q is equal to 2P minus 2Q. This minus 2Q becomes plus 2Q. Plus P becomes minus P. 2P minus P is P. Q plus 2Q is 3Q. P is equal to 3Q. We have value of Q here. Substituting the value of Q, 3 tens are 30. Then 65. Question number 65 is related to analogy. Tiger is related to cub. So tigers, small tiger. So tiger, this is small one, younger one. So tiger's younger one is cub. Young tiger is called as cub. Now elephants, calf, dog, cub, leopard, kitten, horse, fawn is given. So which is correct from these four we have to find out. So tiger's small one is called as cub. This is right. So like that we need to find out the right one. So elephant small one is called as calf, right? Dog's small one is called as puppy, not cub. So this is wrong. Leopards, it is not kitten. Cat, kitten. Leopard is not kitten. Then horse, this is related to deer. Deer's small one is called as fawn but not horse. So this is also wrong. Only first one is correct. So elephant small baby is called as calf. Dog's small baby is not cub. Cub is related to tiger. So cub is related to tiger. Cat, kitten. This is related to deer. Deer's small baby is called as fawn. So these three are wrong. Only the first one is correct. Next, question number 66. What is the area of the square if the length of its diagonal is 13 root 2? This is a square. Diagonal is given 13 root 2. What is the formula for diagonal of a square? Diagonal of a square is S root 2, which is given as 13 root 2. Diagonal of a square formula is S root 2. It is given in the question as 13 root 2. Now root 2 gets cancelled. Then side of the square is 13 units. What he asked to find out? Area. So area of the square is side into side. We got side as 13 units. So 13 into 13 is 169 square units. So second option is the right answer. 169 square units. Next, the pressure inside the cabin of the aircraft flying at an altitude. So when an aircraft is flying at an altitude, so inside the aircraft, what is the pressure? That means the same as outside pressure, or less than that of outside, or more than that of outside, or normal atmospheric pressure at sea level. So what is the pressure inside when it is at an altitude, at a height? When aircrafts are moving at a height, the pressure inside the aircraft will be increased. So which is correct here? More than outside. The pressure inside the aircraft will be increased. So they are pumping some air inside it to maintain the pressure outside and inside. So inside there will be more pressure when compared to the outside. So more than outside. Cost of 2.5 dozen apples is 300. If each apple is sold at 15, so how many dozen here? 2.5 dozen. 1 dozen is 12. So 12 2s are 24, and half dozen is 6. 30. 30 apples are there. Each apple is sold at 15 rupees. So total selling price is 450. Each apple is sold at 15 rupees. Total 30 apples are there. 2.5 dozen means 30. 30 into 15 is 450 rupees. The selling price. And the cost price of the apples is 300. Cost price is 300 and selling price is 450. So he will get profit. How much is the profit? Selling price minus cost price. 450 minus 300. So what is the profit here? 150 rupees profit. So profit by cost price. 300 into 100. So this is profit percentage. So the profit percentage is 50%. Our gain percentage or profit percentage is 50%. Option B is the right answer. See here, very easy to understand. Selling price of 2.5 dozen is, each apple is sold at 15. 15 into 30 is 450. Cost price is 300. So the profit here is 150 rupees profit. Cost price is 300. So profit by cost price into 100, you get profit percentage. The next question is related to general science. Related to DRDO. Akash developed by DRDO is what? So we know that Akash is a missile developed by DRDO, which is a surface to air missile. Surface to air means from earth to air. So targeting anything which comes out from other countries, targeting those. For that purpose, Akash is developed by DRDO to target objects which are coming from other countries. It is a surface to air missile to blast the things which are coming illegally into our country. So it is a surface to air missile system. In a certain town, Saint Bazar is the only option for the people to buy groceries. So if there is only option to buy, then that bazaar is called as monopolistic. Only one seller available, no other competitors for him, so he will become monopolistic. Saint Bazar is the only option for the people to buy groceries. So from this sentence itself we can tell that Saint Bazar is a family owned business. Wrong. Saint Bazar is a supermarket. Saint Bazar has a monopoly in the town. So this is the correct answer. It has monopoly, no other competitors for this bazaar. A healthy market is characterized by competition and not monopoly. So healthy market means it is not about monopoly, it is about competition. If there is more competition, the market will be healthy. If there are less competitors, he will sell whatever he wants. So Saint Bazar is like that. It's the only option to the people to buy groceries. So it is a monopoly here. So option 3 is the right answer. In the town, this is the monopoly. What is the fourth option? Saint Bazar is liked by most people. It is not given in these sentences whether it is liked by people or not, but the only option to buy groceries is Saint Bazar. So it is a monopoly. Question number 71 is related to fractions in arithmetic. Which of the following is the least fraction here? So let us divide this one. 5 ones are 5. Out of 6, 5, 1, 0. 5 twos are 10. 1.2. 3 ones are 3. There will be 10. 3 threes are 9. Here, 2 ones are 2. 10 will be there. 2 fives are 10. 1.5. 4 ones are 4. 4 twos are 8. So 1.25. 5 by 4 is 1.25. So which is the least of all this? Smallest. 1.3, big 1.5. 1.25, 1.2. So 1.2 means nothing is there, means 1.20. Here 1.25. Which is smallest? 1.20 is the smallest.
then 1.25, 1.3, 1.5
in ascending order. So 1.20 is the smallest, 6 by 5 is the smallest one.
Which is the correct order, meaningful order here?
Let us check.
Let us start with the first one. Or otherwise you form a sentence here. Gopu.
So Gopu is a great writer. So Gopu is a great writer. 6, 9.
This is eliminated, eliminated. These two are remaining. 6, 9, then 8. Gopu is a great writer also. So before also we need to get and 5. So 6, 9, 5, 8, 7. Let us check the sentence.
6, 9, 5, 8, 7. 6 Gopu, 9 is a great writer, 5 and 8 also a famous mathematician.
Yes, correct.
Gopu is a great writer and also a famous mathematician.
Option C is the right answer. Next question. A series is given here. How many sevens are immediately followed by 9? Immediately followed by 9, but not preceded by 5. So 5 should not be here. And immediately not preceded by 5. So 7 and 9 should be there, but not 5 in front. So look at 79s. How many 7 9s are here? 7, 9. Should not be 5. Yes. Only 1 here, not 5. Next, another 7, 9. Where is 7, 9? 7, 9, but 5 is here. We need not 5, 7, 9. We don't need 5 here. We need 7, 9, but not 5. 7, 9 here, 5 is there. Leave it. 7, 9. Here, 8. 7, 9 here, 1. We can take this one. 2. Here also 7, 9, but 5 is there. We don't need 5. Here 5 is there, so we cannot take this one. 1, 2. How many times like this?
We have 2 times. 1, 7, 9, 8, 7, 9. But not 5, 7, 9. Don't take 5, 7, 9. We can take any 7, 9s. 1, 7, 9, 8, 7, 9 like that. Here 5, 7, 9. Here also 5, 7, 9 is there. We have not taken these two. 1, 7, 9 and 8, 7, 9. 2. 2 possibilities.
Next. Question number 74. So this is related to current affairs in 2015 because the exam was in 2016. So every question you see in current affairs, the exam NTPC 2016 is asking all current affairs related to 2015. So you need to read current affairs 1 year backwards or 1.5 year back. So you need to read at least 1 to 1.5 year backwards for current affairs. Because all the questions in this paper is related to 2015 current affairs. Cow has been declared as the personality of the year 2015 by. So cow has been declared as the personality of the year 2015 by which of these? So Yahoo India has declared cow as personality of the year because Madhya Pradesh government banned sale of beef in that year. So Yahoo India announced cow as the personality of the year 2015 as Madhya Pradesh has come forward to ban the sale of beef in their state. Next, Zika virus which causes neurological birth disorders. So this Zika virus directly attacks the brain and neurological disorders will come to the child. That means Zika virus is attacked to pregnant women through mosquito bite. Zika virus is transmitted to pregnant women, so the birth of the child will be neurological disorder child. So nervous problem, directly it attacks brain, human brain, and it attacks the nervous system and weakens the bones. So directly it attacks the brain. Zika virus enters into the brain and disorder, nervous system disorder will come for the children and also bones will become very weak for them. The answer for this one is
mosquito bite. The first Zika virus was found in Uganda. First Zika virus case was found in Uganda. The mosquito name is Aegyptis. Aedes aegyptis. So through the mosquito bite, Zika virus is caused to the pregnant women. So no effect on the other people. Zika virus effect will be on only pregnant women. So if they give birth to a child, this pregnant woman with Zika virus, the birth of the child, so the child will become neurological disorder will come to the child because it attacks the brain directly.